AICTE's ban on new colleges. Recently, AICTE has barred the opening up of new technical colleges for at least 5 years. AICTE is a statutory body and a national level council for technical education. It comes under the Department of Higher Education, Ministry of Human Resource Development. It was initially set up in 1945 as an advisory body but later gained the status of a legal body. AICTE is responsible for maintaining the quality of education. It also checks the introduction of new technologies in the courses. Why this decision? AICTE has decided not to accept fresh application for setting up new institutes till 2022. This decision has come up in view of huge numbers of vacant seats in various streams in these colleges as well as low placement ratios. According to AICTE's data, there are a total of 27 lakh seats offering STEM education in India. STEM stands for Science, Technology, Engineering, Mathematics, out of which 14 lakh constitute undergraduate, 11 lakh constitute diploma, and 1.8 lakh postgraduate seats. However, in the year 2019-2020, only 13 lakh of the seats were occupied, and moreover, only 6 lakh could grab a job. These are some shocking figures which show the sad picture of India's engineering colleges. The new AICTE guidelines. The new AICTE guidelines state that private colleges and institutes cannot introduce new courses in conventional fields. Although courses in latest and budding fields such as artificial intelligence, Internet of Things, blockchain, the technology behind Bitcoin, etc., robotics, quantum computing, data sciences, cyber security, 3D printing and design, and augmented reality, virtual reality, AR, VR, can still be introduced. This guideline will come into force from the new academic session, which starts in 2020-21. What led us to this situation? Due to the enormous number of engineering colleges in every lane, the once respectable degree of B.Tech has become a go-to degree easily achievable by money. These colleges thus act as hubs of low-level education, money-making, degree providers, and creators of unemployable and unskilled individuals unfit for working in the industry. Moreover, pursuing B.Tech became a trend, largely because of herd mentality and a common mindset of people who consider science and its related stream superior than any other stream. Because of this, many students willingly or unwillingly end up in engineering colleges every year. Also, students fail to develop or recognize their field of interest during school years due to lack of guidance or ignorance. Sometimes, this is also the result of parental pressures who want their child to become an engineer, whether their child has the aptitude, choice or not for engineering courses. But now, 50% of the seats are rendered vacant. This can be attributed to a variety of reasons. Low employability after completing the courses due to poor hands-on capabilities of students because of outdated curriculums which mismatch with everyday changing technologies or skill sets required for acquiring job. The study material they go through is irrelevant, outdated, purely theoretical, against the need of practical knowledge. On the top of it, poor, inefficient faculty ruin whatever more is left. Another reason for low enrollments can be the high fees which just keep on increasing every year without adding value to a student's creativity, problem-solving abilities, or cognitive abilities. Also, due to a plethora of private institutes which have negligible or zero process of screening, offer easy admissions to the youth. The faculty in such institutions is below the mark. Therefore, the cycle starts and ends up in producing a heap of unemployed and confused people. What must be done? The existing institution must review their curriculums, their course structures, and focus on ways so their students can gain relevant knowledge and are able to apply that knowledge. Therefore, such measures are strongly required in today's scenario to break this vicious cycle, and more stringent measures must be welcome. Apart from this, on an individual level, it is the role of students to make choices for themselves, develop interests, and pursue them. Parents must also realize this fact.
Thanks for watching this video. Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for more such updates. Like and share the video and let us know your queries in the comment section below.